There's no show is a banjo show without a banjo band. And this year, rather than the ragtime as planned, I invited a band from Manchester called the Amiskeg Strummers. And they're a classy little band, and they do a very varied repertoire. And I like them, and I know you will like them. So let's hear the Amiskeg Strummers.
Manchester area, which encompasses the state of New Hampshire from Conway in the north to Pelham in the south to Greenville in the west. Therefore, we are from the greater Manchester area, and so are you. Now, no banjo concert would be complete without some ragtime. And we have here one of the most popular ragtime pieces ever played. I'm sure you all know it. If you know the words, please sing along. It's the ever-popular Persian Lamb Rag by Percy Winrich. So please join us. Then we will follow this up with a brief interlude from the first movement of Easy Winners by the great Scott Joplin. Persian Lamb Rag.
Thank you.
I think you'll agree with me that tonight has been amply demonstrated that the banjo doesn't necessarily have to play 5'2" ad infinitum. It is more fun for the banjo players to come up with new music, music that hasn't been done on the banjo before, or if it has, everybody's forgotten about it. And I'm sure everybody has forgotten about this next one. It's called Anytime, but it's not the country and western Anytime. We'll give this one a shot. Bob Cobb.
Finale, so you'll be able to see him again. Now we're gonna pair up the four that you saw in the front half of the show, and what they're gonna do now is kind of spontaneous. I believe you. I've listened to them for about 4 days now, and every time you hear them, they do something different and something that they don't expect. They do have a program planned, but whether they'll stay to it or not, it all depends upon kind of how they feel and how they react to you as a crowd. So to start off, we're gonna have Mike Asham and Steve De Bonaventure, both fast banjo players, to come out here. They like the fast stuff, as you well know. Come on out, Steve and Mike. They're walking out kind of slow, but then they'll go off fast, that's for sure. And Albie Bernard's going to back them up on the tuba.
already there with the sound? Okay, we're gonna start off with a number called Chinatown and China Boy. Smug up here tonight because we didn't have much time to practice and that came off. So we're all set. We got one out of three. We'd like to slow it down just a little bit with a song called My Near Vista Shame. Thank you. We're supposed to get off here real quick right now, but we'd like to do a song that we did the other night in front of a group and brought the house down. I was real surprised. And it's called That's a Plenty. It's a traditional Dixieland number, but with two banjos and a tuba, I guess it's non-traditional, so we'll do it our way. It's called That's a Plenty.
We've heard from them young guys. They're gonna pull out the old master and his sidekick. I'll let them figure out who's who there. We know who the old master is, that's for sure. Old master and the new master. These guys really produce magic. They've only been playing together for maybe about 6 months or a year, seriously, and they're going to make a tape, I understand, and they're both part of a banjo international tour of Germany, which starts in October, Sandy plus several, and Buddy and several others. And when they sit down, there is some magic that happens between them, so we'll let them take over the mics now. Sandy and Buddy Watcher, and backed up by Big Sut.
This is a tune that I learned when I was...
Oh, you're going to do it. Good.
Yeah, 10 years old. And we're going to do it. It only takes about 1 minute.
It's faster than that.
Old banjo classic, written by Ralph Colicchio.
Who's he?
I don't know who he's with. He asked those questions.
He was an accordion player.
Yeah. I always wanted to see Dolly Parton play the accordion.
Thank you.
little waltz.
My dad's favorite.
Your dad's favorite.
My dad's favorite. My Gus Allen. Two lovely waltzes. Feel free to sing on these.
Yeah.
Aren't they great, huh? Aren't they great? Magic was together. We're getting close to our finale, and we got one more song that the Amherst drummers are going to do at my request, because there's a little gal in the band that has a great voice, and I want you to hear it. Arlene Butcher, and I guess they're going to do Cakewalk and Baby, right? No? Gee, I thought they wanted to play Baby. It's my favorite. All right, well, whatever they do, it will be good. The Amherst drummer.
Actually, the song we're going to be doing is called After You've Gone. Is that okay? Now listen, honey, baby, while I say, how can you tell me that you're say that we must part. You know I've loved you, babe, for many a year. Loved you night and day. Now don't you leave me, don't be mean, my dear, and listen to me while I say. Friend you ever had. There'll come a time, now don't forget it. There'll come a time when you'll regret it. Someday, when you feel lonely, you'll think of me, my dear, and you want me only. After you've gone, after you've gone away.
And to start, I'd like to have Herbie Webster. Last year I called him Herbie Philbrick, and I didn't do it this year. Herbie Webster, our piano player. John Stewart, the tuba player, the rhythm section. And shot kid. He's even shorter than I am. Steve, to Bonaventure. He says, can I wave to the people as I go by? I said, sure you can. Mike Hashem and his tuba player. Albie Bernard. John Battis, the clarinet player, had to go along, so he's been good. Big Sutton and Sandy. You know, Big Sutton, Sandy, come on out here. We wouldn't mind. Buddy Watcher. Buddy, come on. We're gonna play a famous old banjo song for you so we can end that program. Mike? Thank you so much. You've been a wonderful audience.